Good morning. Let us start our fifth chapter from the EVS. Our fifth chapter topic, Sustainable Development Goals. We heard this term, Sustainable Development, very frequent manner. What is Sustainable Development Goals? We can discuss Sustainable Development Goals in this chapter. Social first topic in this chapter is social issues and the environment. Sustainable development. First we have to understand about sustainable development. Sustainable development is the maintenance of a long lasting and healthy environment for the welfare of present and the future generation. This concept was developed by world leaders in the Earth Summit at Rio, Brazil in 1992, meeting of UN Conference on Environment and Development. What are the reasons or causes of the unsustainability? Overuse of pesticides, industrialization, overgrazing of animals, cow, dog, many goats, many animals are eating grasses. So due to their overgrazing, the land become dry. That we studied this pollution and problems of environment were we studied. Then hunting of animals, urbanization, then deforestation, modernized agriculture, pollution are the major reasons of the unsustainability. Then what are the methods for sustainable development? Population control to reduce demand for natural resources, stop hunting, conserve water, rainwater harvesting, control mining, use organic fertilizer, use biopesticides, give public awareness. Then urban problems related to energy. Urban problems, urbanization result in thick population in urban area. Population are living in a limited place. In a flat, so many people are living. The increase of demand for energy, this increases demand for energy. So many people are there, our energy is very limited. So many people are demanding energy. This problem created to the energy. Following activities need more energy. Their daily life routine have require more energy. Industries want more energy. Residential area also want more energy. Commercial purpose, automobile purpose, every sectors are need energy. What are the impact of the overuse of the energy, shortage of water, soil pollution, air pollution, water pollution, noise pollution, spread of diseases. These pollutions we have already studied in the last chapter, then no need to explain again. Then what are the remedies for this problem? Use alternate energy. There are different source of energy, you can use that also. Then use public solar energy, we can utilize that. Then from the natural resources also, not only water source, but now bio-friendly energy sources are there. We can utilize that also. Then use public transportation system. We use water in a limited quantity and limited use of electricity. Then what are the methods, strategies for water conservation, recycling, drip irrigation, limited use of water for domestic purpose, reuse, avoid wastage of water, rainwater harvesting. And what are the method of water conservation? Rainwater harvesting, store rainwater for future use. Then methods of rainwater harvesting. Rainwater is directly collected on vessels, on ports and tanks, and used for drinking, cooking and bathing. Construct pits, kuli, and store water into pit. Recharge well. We can construct well and we can recharge well in the rainy season. Store in ponds. Then we can store water in open places by constructing any big tanks. Then uses to get water for domestic purpose. Reduce water scarcity. Increase water reserves. Increase water table. Increase quality of water. And it can also a great help to reduce flood. Then watershed management. Watershed is an area of land that catches rain, drain water, some sediments and materials to a common body or outlet. It is the land through which water flows, may have any shape, cross country and state boundary. The watershed contains flowing water, still water and upland water. Biotic and abiotic factors also consist. Activities for watershed management are conservation of village, erosion control, tree planting, irrigation, water conservation, farmland protection, prevention of landslide, pest management, scientific mining, scientific coring. By this method, we can conserve the water. Then, resettlement. Resettlement is shifting of people from their native place to a new area by providing a land. Resettlement means, yesterday in the earlier class, we discussed about the resettlement and rehabilitation in the topic disaster management. Resettlement is shifting of people from their native place to a new area by providing a land. What are the causes for resettlement? What are the reason for this resettlement? For the construction of dam, road, airport, highway, wildlife sanctuary, we need more area. So government is compelling people to shift their area. Then rot. If any area become dry land, people cannot live in that area. War, famine, cyclone, earthquake, flood, mining. That is accidentally disasters also. During that time, people must be shifted from that area. Then what are the difficulties in resettlement? No one likes to give up their own house in which he live. We are not ready to give up our own area. Then no one likes to give up his own land. Because we are living in our land, our property is there, our house is there, every factors are there. So no one is ready to give up these factors. Then tribal will stay only in their place. Tribals will stay only in the forest area. Then people cannot adopt new place. Then rehabilitation. The facilities provided to the resettled people to satisfy their needs in the new area are called rehabilitation. Facilities provided to the resettled people to satisfy their needs in the new area are called rehabilitation. What are the activities for rehabilitation? Construction of house, free medical service, protection from native people and wild animals by arranging security guard, psychological service, because at that time we are very tensed. When we are giving our place to government, when we are changing our living area to another area, at that time we have so many mental, physical tension. So we must have psychological counseling, land substitution, then employment generation programs. The national policy for rehabilitation and resettlement. India promulgated a draft national policy for rehabilitation and resettlement in 1998. Two public sector companies have formulated policies on resettlement and rehabilitation. Indian National Thermal Power. Two public sector companies formulated policies for resettlement and rehabilitation are Indian National Thermal Power, Coal India Corporation Limited. Then some NGO working for rehabilitation. Then later, government rejected rehabilitation policies. So many non-governmental organizations are working now Now, government is not involved in rehabilitation policies in a good manner. Then, next topic is environmental ethics. Environmental ethics is the scientific view of various issues related to the right of individuals on environment. Environmental ethics is maintained by the following methods: equitable utilization of natural resources, equity among countries, rural and urban people, male and female, then conservation of resources for future generation, protect animals, prevent hunting, environmental education, conservation of traditional values, respect living things, plants and both plants and animals, then use eco-friendly products, keep environment neat and clean. Okay, today we discussed about resettlement and resettlement policies and rehabilitation programs and environmental